Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. In this video, we will talk about weakness, also known as fatigue. If you were seen in the emergency department for weakness and were discharged, but have any of the following, please return immediately. If you have confusion or agitation, increased anxiety or irritability, fever or vomiting, severe headache, any signs of stroke like paralysis, numbness of one side of the body, or drooping one side of the face, or trouble talking. Also worsening weakness, difficulty standing, paralysis, loss of control of bladder or bowel, or difficulty swallowing. We must make a difference between true weakness and fatigue. It is important to understand the difference between true weakness, real weakness from a nerve or brain problem, and the more common problem of fatigue. These words might seem similar, but they do mean very different problems. Let's start with fatigue. When a person is describing fatigue, they may feel tired out very quickly, even with just very little activity. They may also say they're feeling tired, sleepy, easily exhausted, and unable to do normal daily activities because they don't seem to have enough energy. Some of the factors are stress, overwork, chronic fatigue, nutritional factors, and medications. True weakness, on the other hand, is when somebody has true weakness, it means that the muscles are not working right. For example, a leg might truly be weak when you can't support your weight on it or you can't stand up from a chair. This might mean that the muscles itself either are losing their strength or the nerves going to them are not conducting electricity adequately. The causes of weakness are multiple, but include infection, like urinary tract infections, pneumonias, and cellulitis. Electrolyte imbalance, like sodium, potassium, calcium, and other electrolytes. Dehydration. Also heart disease. And any kind of neurologic problems, like stroke or peripheral nerve problems. The workup of weakness includes blood work, set of x-rays, urinalysis, and often even CT scans of your head to make sure there's not a stroke or focal lesion. Follow-up. It's very important that if you're watching this video, you were probably discharged with non-specific weakness. We could not find a specific cause of your weakness. You need to follow up with your primary doctor so he can do further tests like MRIs and rheumatologic tests, serologic tests, etc., to really define why you're feeling weak. Also, he's more able to determine if maybe a combination of your medications or a medication's side effect in particular is causing your weakness. For more videos like this video, please go to edexitvideo.com.